Hello, my friends. My name is Patty. I am one of the teachers at Berkshire Yoga Dance and Fitness, and I am so happy to welcome you to my apartment and to welcome you to Lunch Break Yoga. We at Berkshire Yoga Dance and Fitness are so committed to being here for you and with you through the whole duration of our time inside, our time to focus, our time to think. And we invite you to join us in all the classes that we are offering online. There is also a way to make a donation if you are able. A PayPal button at the bottom of the Berkshire Yoga page that will go to support the studio and to help us continue our efforts and also to make it possible for us to reopen with so much joy when that time comes. But for today, I'm offering a restorative class. I offer restorative at least once a month in my normal practice. It's important, and maybe now more important than ever, but it also might be harder. It might be more challenging for you to settle and calm down. So I'm going to encourage you to join me today in restorative class. Here's what you'll need. You'll need two big fluffy pillows, whatever you've got on your bed. Somewhere, I've got two right here. And then get yourself two soft blankets. We're gonna use all of these. You go ahead and get them and I'll wait here for you. I'll speak a little bit about what restorative yoga is. We so often talk about us doing yoga. Restorative yoga is allowing the yoga poses basically to do us. And our challenge through restorative yoga is to keep our body and our spirit calm. And as I say, in this current situation, in our current environment, that may be the hardest challenge of all yoga right now, is maintaining the breath and staying calm. So I invite you to join me. If you find it's too much, it's too difficult, pause. Do 20 minutes, come back, do the last 20 minutes at another time. Listen to your body. Listen to your spirit. Take this moment, turn inward, take care of you. But I encourage you, restorative yoga is an important part of every practice. When we come back to our new normal, keep restorative yoga in mind as part of your weekly experience of yoga. So we're going to start out by taking the one blanket and putting it down on top of the mat. So that right away signals to your body that this is going to be a different kind of a yoga practice. We're going to soften the experience right from the very beginning. And then take your two pillows, and this may take a little adjusting. I'm going to take two pillows on top of that blanket. I'm going to bring my bottom right to the base of these pillows. Now, these are pretty long pillows. You might want to put one here, one there. See what works for you, for your body, for your setup. And then once you have your bottom at the base of the pillows, just slowly bring yourself down. Use your elbows if that's necessary. Bring yourself into a comfortable position so that your lower back is not feeling compromised in any way at all. If you have to move down, if you need to move up, adjust until you are comfortably supported here on this stack of pillows. Now, legs. You can put your feet wide and let your knees bump together so that your legs are supporting each other. You can let your legs go long on the mat if that feels comfortable. Again, we're going to be in this position for several minutes. You need to be comfortable. You need to be able to let the pillows support you, and you need to be able to let go. So adjust. And then once you're comfortable, I'll invite you to turn your gaze up towards the ceiling. Bring your arms out from your body so that they're forming a letter A with your body. I have my palms up, but palms up or palms down is your choice. You decide. what feels better, what feels secure, what feels more comforting. And then breathe. Turn your attention to the flow of air into and out of your body. Don't change your breath. Don't change its tempo or its pace. Just bring your mind's attention to your breath. Allow your mind to just take a back seat to this practice. Allow your breath to lead. There are so many things on our minds right now, so many things going through our minds. And asking that to stop, I know, is a big challenge. And so what we can do is we can allow the mind to continue to do what the mind always does. Let the thoughts come, let the thoughts go. Don't engage them. Engage the breath. Feel the pattern of the breath moving through your body. Feel the gentle rhythm of air coming into your nose, down through your body, into your lungs, circulating around and then releasing back out into the space around you. Sometimes it helps to picture the breath as a color. If you put a color to your breath, whatever color comes to your heart and to your spirit right now. For me, for some reason, it's blue. You can see the breath blue and picture it coming in through your nose and allowing it to move through vocal cords, air passages, lung capacity. And then as the lungs release the air back through the windpipe, through the nostrils, and out into the space you occupy, wherever it is you've made your space right now. Just breathe. This pose is a heart opener. It is a lung opener, a front body opener. We're allowing the rib cage to expand with the help of the pillows. Allowing the heart to rest in the body. We're allowing the breath to nourish and sustain the body. If your mind begins to wander, use a mantra, a word, a phrase that is special for you. I often use the phrase, I am breathing in, I am breathing out. heart to open, allowing the heart to receive pranayama, life force energy. On your next in-breath, move your tongue around the roof of your mouth. It indicates to the body that a transition is about to happen. And then wherever your legs are, bring your feet close to your bottom, bend your knees up to the sky. And carefully, gently, roll over onto your right side. Come up on your right elbow. And take one of those pillows and bring it in front of your body. You're going to bring the left knee onto the pillow. If that doesn't feel like enough support, you can fold the pillow in half. I still have one under my body. Going to lower back down, use my bottom arm for my support, for my pillow. I'm going to bring my top hand, my left hand, to my left hip flexor. I want to keep that left shoulder open. So I want this pose to be the left side opener, to open this rib cage up towards the left, and putting that left hand back onto the hip helps. And again, adjust this pillow so that that left knee feels support, but you have a wide open hip flexor here. Bottom arm is your pillow for your head. You should not be hanging off a pillow or dangling or uncomfortable in any way. So again, take a time, take a moment to adjust. Take time to make this a comfortable place to be. And then again, allow the breath to become the focus. Breathing in. Breathing out. Left side body. Receiving the energy from above. Moon and stars. Energy all around us. We come into a full moon on Saturday night this week. Right side body. Receiving the energy of the earth, Mother Earth beneath, supporting and holding that entire length of the right side body. I have my right leg extended out long on the mat so that I can feel the earth beneath me all the way down from the top of my head to my toes. Breathing in. Breathing out. And relax. feel tension creeping anywhere into your body, send the breath there. Imagine your breath coming in through your nose, going perhaps to your hip flexor, perhaps to your lower back, perhaps to your knee or ankle. If there's a sign, if some part of your body is indicating tension, allow your breath to go there. We can do this with our mind's eye. We can do this in our imagination. We can see the breath, and we can send it wherever it's needed. Breathing in, breathing out. Again, if mind starts to wander, use a mantra. Use one you know. Om Namo Bhagavate Namaha. Wahe Guru. Sat Nam. Repeat over and over and over again. I am breathing in. I am breathing. Left side body open to the moon and the stars, the energy of the planets all around us. Right side body receiving the comfort, the nourishment, the strengthening of the earth. Again, on your next in-breath, begin to move your tongue around the roof of your mouth. It indicates to the body transition is about to happen. And then slowly, 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 I can't emphasize that word enough, slowly. Begin to move towards your back. Roll over, lifting that top knee, that left knee, onto your back. And pause here just for a moment as we readjust. Now take that pillow that you just used for your left knee, bring it over to the left side of your body. Left leg goes long on the mat. Right knee comes over the pillow. I'm going to rearrange myself just so that I'm facing you. You stay where you are. I want to be facing towards you. Left leg is long on the mat. Right knee is extended onto the pillow, left arm under the head for support.
We want to keep that right shoulder open. So right hand comes to right side. Allowing the right rib cage now to get the energy from above, the moon and the starlight, the energy that comes from them. And left side body receives the energy from Mother Earth. Again, I have my left leg extended long on the mat so that I can feel the earth beneath me from the top of my elbow, my bent arm, all the way down to the tips of my toes. Adjust that pillow under that right knee until it's comfortable, and then breathe. Life force energy supporting and sustaining this body at rest. Restorative yoga teaches us that we need to sleep and we need to rest. This is conscious rest. This is allowing the body to slow down and receive energy, rather than speeding up and creating energy. This is the receiving of energy. Again, if you sense tension anywhere within your body, hip flexor, knee, ankle, lower back, perhaps the side of the body that's on the ground might be tense. Picture your breath going there. Envision breath coming in through your nose, down through vocal cords and lungs, and then spreading out from the lungs, whooshing into whatever part of your body is holding tension. Allow the breath to heal. Allow the breath to nourish and sustain. Life force energy body needs sleep and the body needs rest. Breathing in, breathing out. Sending breath to places where tension is appearing. So as you rest, as you allow the body to rest, the tension may appear, maybe not at first, but maybe as we take this prolonged pose, you might feel, you might sense a place where tension has been stored deep inside your body. Send the breath. again, move your tongue around the roof of your mouth to indicate transition is coming. Let the body know. Legs back together. And then gently using that top arm, bottom elbow, lift yourself up. We want this bottom pillow now to go long way across the mat, across the blanket. And we're going to take the second pillow for under the knees. So first bring yourself in a position where that bottom pillow is across the center of your back. This may mean your head is hanging off just a little bit. If that's uncomfortable, use your second blanket for support. If that doesn't feel good on your neck, bring that second blanket into play. If you're okay with this, then allow that second pillow to go under your knees. Again, I'm going to bunch mine up. This pillow is a little flat. Years of use. So one pillow across the middle of the back, one pillow under the knees, blanket at the head if you need it. Arms come out to a T. Gaze is up to the ceiling. And breathe. Again, ribcage, heart opener. Because of the position of the pillow under the knees, also opening the pelvic region, the pit of the belly. Opening through the lymph glands under the armpits. If you're able to allow your head to rest on the floor, it is a modest inversion. Your heart here is higher than your head. And so blood flow direction changes. And breathe. I am breathing in, I am breathing out. Allowing back body to receive the energy of Mother Earth, allowing front body to be open to the energy of the moon and the stars, planets, all the sources of energy around us we don't even see. Breathing in the breath of life.
using a mantra, using a word or a sound that brings comfort. I am breathing in. I am breathing out. Allowing the body to be at rest, to receive energy. Feeling the energy of the earth, sensing the energy of the earth from fingertips on the right hand, along the back of the arm, through the shoulders, up the right side of the head, down the left side, out through the shoulder blade on the left to the fingertips. Draw that line in your mind and see the energy of the earth just nourishing these parts of the body. Fingers, wrists, elbows, shoulders, across the middle back, that thoracic spine segment. Up and over the head, through the base of the skull, that occipital ridge, picture the energy of the earth massaging from shoulder blades down. Down the back, down the torso, over the hips, backs of the legs, hamstrings and calves, ankles, and then bring that vision of massage up the soles of the feet and allow the front body to feel the energy from the moon and the stars, moon dust, stardust, just tinkling down across the tops of your feet, ankles, shins and your knees, up your thighs and across your hips and your belly, the front of your body. To your rib cage and your heart, feel the energy, the tingling, the light. Your neck and your jaw, touching your cheeks and your forehead. Breathing in, breathing out. Again, on your next in-breath, roll your tongue around the roof of your mouth. Let your body know, let your body sense the transition is coming. And bring your feet in close to your body. Let's push this bottom pillow away. And we're going to roll over onto our belly. Again, I'm going to reposition so that I'm looking at you. You want the pillow directly across your midsection, so right at the base of your breast, and then bring your head down onto the floor in front of you. So you're going to create a stack of your palms. You're going to put your right palm down and your left palm on top so that you can put your forehead down. Back up just a bit. Again, this front pillow is right across your midsection. Stack of palms, forehead straight down, legs out long behind you. Now allowing front body to receive the energy of the earth. And allowing back body to be opened. This stack of palms under your forehead, supporting your forehead, allows that thoracic spine to just open up to the energy of the moon and stars above. Forehead down. Breathing in, breathing out. Sensing tension, sensing a feeling of tightness or tension anywhere in the body, allow the breath to go directly there. Picture the breath coming in through your nose, through your air passages to your lungs, and then spreading out from the lungs to wherever it's needed. Perhaps it's your lower back now that might feel slightly tense. Perhaps it's the hip flexors, or even the knees or the feet. If you feel any tension, shoulders, anywhere in your body, allow your breath to go there. Breathing in, breathing out. Again, doing that scan, picturing the energy of the earth touching your toes, touching your feet, your ankles, the front of your shins, your knees, your thighs, the energy of the earth coming up into your pelvic region, your belly pit, your front body, rib cage, heart, extending up to the forehead and then spreading out through the arms, the front of the forearm, the elbows, touching the front of the shoulders, picture the energy of the moon and the stars touching your back body, the soles of your feet, the heels, the calf muscles, the back of your knee, the hamstrings, your bottom, your waist, your low back, your coccyx bone. Picture the moon and the stars sending energy and light up your spinal cord, radiating out through the back body, ribs, shoulders, the back of the head, and then touching the front of the arms. On your next in-breath, tongue rolls around top of the mouth. Bring your hands back to frame your face and gently, easily come up onto all fours into a gentle seated position, whatever that looks like for you. Just a moment here, allowing your body to rearrange its position in the world, its relationship to gravity. And then on your next in-breath, let your arms come out wide to a T. Palms facing forward, wiggle your fingers, roll your wrists. Roll your wrists in the opposite direction. Feel the space you occupy in this world. Inhale, let your arms come up to moon and stars, the energy that's available to us every day. Let your palms touch here, Anjali Mudra, bringing hands slowly down, full of energy from moon and stars, stardust, moonlight. Release your thumbs, let them come to heart center, chin drops to chest. You are amazing. You are unique. In all the world, there has never been anyone like you. There never will be. And as you touch your own heart center, feel that. Feel that energy radiating from your heart. Each one of us has gifts to give to this world, and right now it may be more challenging than ever, but the gifts are here in heart center, and so is everyone you love, and so is everyone who has ever loved you, right here. feel their presence. Send out your love into this world. Radiate from wherever you are. Energy can travel through walls and doors and across thousands of miles. We know that. We know that more now, perhaps, than we ever knew it before. Allow your heart center to radiate love and energy into this world. And my heart center is radiating love to you and for you. Namaste. Be safe. See you soon.